So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to set up your farm. And to do that, we go into the options menu. And we won't go through all of these options in this video, but just some of the most common or important ones. In here, you type your farm name, which will show on some reports. You don't necessarily need to fill out all of these, but this would be the farm name you want to show on reports. Application format, this is important. Gregorian date format is the common calendar month. But for those of you who prefer to use what's called a 1,000-day calendar, you would check this serial date. And you can switch back and forth. Calendar week rule, this is for. There are several options in here for numbering your weeks in some reports, and there's different depending on how you define your week, you would change your settings in here. And this is for the start of week, your production week. Some farms, their production week goes from, for example, Sunday to Saturday. Some may start Monday to Sunday. So you want to select the day of the week for reporting purposes, and I'll show you why that's important in a few minutes. The other thing you're going to want to do in here is event fields. If you click right here, that'll expand that. Breeding females. This is a list of all the events in a female file for the sows. And these are switches for all the fields. You can turn them on and off. So you probably won't use all of these events, but for the ones you do, this facilitates data entry. You can turn these fields on and off depending if you use them or not. For example, if you don't record sire and dam when you enter a new gilt, you don't want to have to enter through fields with no data, so you can turn them off. This form is for the fast entry. The batch is for the batch. It looks like a spreadsheet screen, and this is for the handheld device. So you would go through here, and again, this is insemination event, for example. I want to record the semen code, the technician. I don't care to put in a dose or the hour. I want to put in a breeding group. So you might want to add a comment, for example. So these are, you'd go through here and configure all your events before you start entering data. Another thing that's important to note in here are time intervals. And here's where you're going to set things like days from service to preg check. These are all going to be time intervals, days for some of your management lists. So, for example, if you like to have a pregnancy checklist at 30 days, this is where you would put that number or change it. If you want it 35 days, for example, you would change that here. Gestation length, the average here, 115 days. Some herds may have an average of 116 days or 114 days. You can change that in here. And pre-farrow, some of these can be changed right within the report, and I'll show you that in a little bit. But this is for your sow cards, for example. This shows the due date. It's going to calculate 115 days, and this is where that's where it's going to get that number. For those of you who have a brand new database and you're entering sows for the first time, you're going to have to define things like genetics. And in here, you just simply click the new button, type in the new genetics, and save. Those of you who've had had a database converted from another software program, during the conversion process, Porcitec should have converted your previous genetic codes, and that's true for pretty much any of the codes that you had for technicians or treatments or pig death reasons or removal reasons. Those should have all been converted, and you would see them in the list here. You can turn them on and off if you don't use them anymore. For example, just click the active or inactive, because then it won't show on your drop-down lists. So you'll want to do that for genetics. I recommend always entering a genetics when you first enter new gilts, even if they're all the same, because you never know down the road at some point in the future. If you change genetics, you're going to want to compare those. So I always recommend putting in genetics when you enter new gilts. The other thing you're going to want to do is add removal reasons. These are for culls and deaths of sows or boars. And again, if you had your database converted, you should see your reasons already in there. Otherwise, you simply start adding new ones. I should mention too that codes in here in the options menu, and this is true for all of them, are case sensitive. So meaning if you type a capital letter and then the next time you add it with the lowercase, it's going to treat it like two different reasons. So you want to be sure to make the decision at the beginning if you're going to be consistent with using all uppercase or all lowercase or whatever combination. And then again, pre-weaning death reasons, this is for baby pigs, and you'll want to add those if they're not already coded for you. Technician, if you want to keep track of your breeding technicians, farrowing technicians, some events will have a place where you can add the person that is doing the event so that you can monitor that. And we are just talking about the breeding herd today, so I'm not going to go through all of the options for setting up growing and feed, but that's all in here too. So feed is in here, and their production stages and locations, those are all for growing, and that will be for a video at another time.